Welcome to Look Smarter Than You Are with FDMEE Custom Reports. This video will focus on creating a query definition. The query definition is the data logic portion of the FDMEE reports. The FDMEE query definition screen stores the query against the FDMEE tables to produce the necessary report. The select clause brings back rows of data for the necessary report. The where clause applies filters to that data. Finally, the group by and order by clause allow for the report to be easily. Finally, the group by or order by clause structures the data in a way that allows the report engine to produce a report efficiently. As a starting point, copy out the select clause, where clause, and order by clause. Paste the copied SQL from FDMEE into Oracle SQL Developer. Use the Control Function 7 key to format the SQL into a more easy to read layout. Alternatively, using SQL Developer 4.0 or higher, you can switch to the Query Builder mode. This provides a more simplified way in which to build a query by simply placing a check in the column of interest. Also within this view, we can see how tables are joined together. For the nature of this video, we will be creating a custom report that will list the locations within our FDMEE application, the category or scenarios that are being loaded, and the data load rules used by those locations. Here we have a simple select statement against the TPOV partition, bringing back the partition name column, which is the location name, the TPOV category cat name column, which is the category, and finally the AIF balance rules rule name column, which is the rule name. The necessary joins are in place, and the data returned will be sorted by location, category, and then load rule. We will take this query built in SQL Developer and bring it back into FDMEE. Create a new query definition, supplying the name, location, data load rules, pasting in our SQL from SQL Developer in the select portion and the order by portion. Once the SQL is in place, save and validate. If written properly, we should see query validation successful. Finally, in order to create a layout, we need a sample data set. This is done by clicking Generate XML. When clicked, we will be prompted to save or open a file. It is best to save this file and then to be used later. In opening our XML data file, we can see the structure and return data. We have a row with a location, a category, and data load rule. In the next video, we will work with creating a report layout. Thank you.